Adam Johnson has been following the story all morning from the GE perspective. So we know this must be a good day for GE shareholders and a good day for Jeff Immelt.
As a matter of fact, GE trading up initially, the first prints up over 1%. So obviously this is the deal the market wants to see. The new GE, this is what the market wants. We've been talking about how Immelt has been effectively remaking the house that Jack built. Let's talk about what that looks like. All right, first of all, you've got what was NBC as 11% of GE. Well, that now shrinks to 5%, and in theory, they may get rid of it altogether. You've got GE Capital taking that down below 30%, call it 20%, have been as high as 40%, and of course, focusing really on where they really want to put their firepower, and that is tech infrastructure and energy infrastructure. You'll see those two increase in size as a part of the GE pie. Now, with regards to GE Capital specifically, there's going to be a conference call next Tuesday. Goldman Sachs, Terry Darling, telling investors buy calls ahead of this call. Why? Because each of the past three quarters ahead of that conference call occurred, and then the stock traded up another 13 to 14% over the next several days. So obviously, that's a catalyst for the stock. Now you've got this official announcement. That's another catalyst. We talk about the stock already up 1%. It's the GE that the market wants to see, Deirdre.
Not to rain on GE's parade, because as you mentioned, the market is responding well. But GE Capital, you mentioned its changing landscape within the company as well. There's a lot of analysts who are fairly bearish on GE for this reason alone, saying they have tons of real estate exposure, and this is really going to hurt GE's bottom line, continue to hurt it.
Yeah, and that may be in part why GE almost had to do this deal. They're going to get some cash. We're still getting the details in terms of exactly how much cash, because they will also contribute some debt from the current GE structure. So once we net that out, yes, GE will get several billion dollars of cash. It may need to use that cash against potential future losses at GE Capital. But the point is, Jeff Immelt moving beyond that, changing the face of GE. He's even tried to sell the consumer business. And another key point I want to make, research and development, that has come way down at GE. Expect to see that go up. It got down to as low as 2%, used to be 7%. The industrial average is 5%. He's got to get that back up. And why? Because GE has lagged so dramatically. The worst performing of the 25 industrial stocks, up only 4%, but moving this morning, so stay tuned.
All right, Adam, thanks very much. Adam Johnson on the GE part of the story.